Sri Lanka may seem to you like a small island in southern Asia, but when it comes to tourism, it offers so much more. Sri Lanka is an island country in South Asia and was formerly known as Ceylon. It has been ruled by many popular empires like the French, Portuguese, and the British. And before that, it passed under the rules of many other civilizations. Therefore, as you move around Sri Lanka, you'll witness many outstanding, marvelous historic sites that boast rich history and culture. Sri Lanka, being an island country, does not only provide historic tourism, but its natural attractions compete for side-by-side as well. Sandy beaches, palm trees, evergreen forests, towering mountains, tea and rubber plantations, beautiful scenery, and plentiful wildlife spotting opportunities are the reason why the country is the top tourist destination lately. Here are the top 10 tourist attractions in Sri Lanka. Number 10, Arugam Bay. Sri Lanka has some of the supreme beaches in the world. Some of those beaches are in the Arugam Bay area. Arugam Bay is a laid-back tourist destination. It's a brilliant surfing spot and is recognized as the top surf destination in the world. Since Sri Lanka has a coastline of over 1,600 kilometers, it is best suited for water sports like windsurfing, speedboating, snorkeling, and other activities. Among the three surf areas, the main point is ideal for intermediate and expert surfers, while Whiskey Point or Peanut Farm are for beginners. If you're looking to relax, then the sandy beach looking over turquoise-colored water can't be more of a relaxing treat. Or you can book a beach house for a night and enjoy the view from the hotel. The Arugam Bay also has many restaurants that serve classic Sri Lankan cuisine. Number 9. Marissa. Right after Arugam Bay is another beautiful beach town, Marissa. If you've ever imagined a perfect beach vacation, Marissa might fulfill your dream. Marissa contains two beautiful beaches, Marissa Beach and Secret Beach. The beach is surrounded by coconut palms and laid with golden soft sand adjacent to crystal blue water, gives a mesmerizing sight and wholesome experience. The best part is, you won't find either of the two beaches crowded. Visitors can enjoy both day and night trips in this place. It's a perfect place for dolphin and whale watching, while snorkeling, surfing, and other water activities are always there. For an amazing view of the sea and its surroundings, head over to Parrot Rock right off the beach. The summit of the rock can be reached via a staircase that offers majestic views of the ocean and the coastline. Night trips are party ventures where visitors can head over to the beach clubs and enjoy cocktails. Number 8. Anuradhapura. An ancient city that dates back to the 3rd century BC, Anuradhapura is a sacred city to the locals. The sacred city was established by the founder of a Buddhist order. The city is one of the three corners of Sri Lanka's cultural triangle and is claimed as UNESCO World Heritage Site. Anuradhapura flourished for 1,300 years with thriving palaces, temples, and monuments, but was abandoned after it was invaded in the late 10th century. Tourists come to this place to explore its ancient history and well-preserved ruins. There's a Bodhi tree in Mahamuna Garden, which is said to be the oldest known human-planted tree in the world. It is said to be the south branch of a sacred fig tree in India. There's another good site near the town known as Mihintale. The mountain's summit serves as a spiritual spot from where, as per stories, Buddhism was introduced in the country. Number 7. Adam's Peak. Adam's Peak is a popularly known location worldwide. The peak lies on a large mountain of around 7,360 feet and is considered sacred in many religions. A mountain? Sacred? Yes, it is. The summit shoulders a large boulder that has an imprint of a foot. Whose can it be? Every religion has claimed the footprint to be of their significant religious person. For Muslims and Christians, the footprint is of Adam. For Buddhists, it is of Buddha. And for Hindus, the footprint was created by Shiva. From a tourist point of view, it is an amazing place. There's a steep staircase of 5,000 steps that links the ground to the summit. The staircase trail has many stalls and food shops for visitors to take a bite and relax. For a wild adventure, tourists start the hike at 2 a.m. to reach the summit at the time of sunrise and witness the sun spreading its light around Sri Lanka. Magical. Number 6. Dambula Cave Temple. We have another religious site, and that is Dambula Cave Temple. You may have seen temples on the ground, but Sri Lanka has turned its natural caves into cave temples after enlarging and excavating them. One of those cave temples is Dambula. The temple is a sacred Buddhist site and also UNESCO World Heritage Site. Pilgrims from all over the world visit this place to pay respect to Buddha. The cave is full of devotees on full moon days, since there is no entry fee at that time as well. Visitors can enjoy the temple architecture and colorful wall murals that signify the cave walls. They can take pictures or pay respect to a large golden Buddha statue outside the temple as well. It is because of the statue The temple is also known as the Golden Temple of Dambulla. Do cover the shoulders and legs if a trip to the temple is planned. Number 5. Yala National Park. Want to experience the popular Sri Lankan safari? Visit the Yala National Park. The national park surrounds the Indian Ocean and inhabits a variety of different ecosystems. It is having a high density of leopards, hence it is highly likely to be spotted. Other large populated animals include elephants, crocodiles, water buffaloes, peacocks, fowls, mongoose, and sloth bears. It seems like a pleasant wildlife tour. The park is a treat for animal lovers. While entering the park, make sure to visit the visitor center for an insightful display of the park. Then ride towards the only two blocks that are open to the public, while the other three are blocked for the safari to preserve the land. The park is also a pilgrimage site, as the temples of Sitil Pahula and Magul Vihara are situated there that attracts many visitors as well. Number 4. Palun Narua. Located in the north-central province of Sri Lanka, Palun Narua is the third corner of the cultural triangle and a UNESCO World Heritage Site. It also has the remains of an ancient kingdom of Palun Narua, which was founded in the Chola dynasty. Kings used to rule Sri Lanka through this place 800 years ago. It was then a flourishing religious and commercial center. Nowadays, the glorious site attracts many visitors due to its well-preserved history and ruins, as it is considered one of the greatest planned archaeological relic cities. The ruins include royal palaces, spaces, quadrangles, and dagobas. Gal Vihara is a famous site that can be found in Palun Narua. It is a famous Buddhist site as it depicts one of the best sculptures of Buddhism. The site has many caves and large sculptures of Buddha carved into rock faces. Number 3. Sigiriya Rock Fortress. Apart from Adam's Peak, another unique rock formation in Sri Lanka is Sigiriya Rock Fortress. Its summit was once an island king's throne, which was believably constructed during the 4th and 5th centuries CE. It lies at a height of 660 feet. Currently, it offers breathtaking scenery from the summit and a chance to explore the fortress remains. Tourists can reach the summit via a steep staircase of around 1,200 steps. The staircase leads to other frescoes as well that serve as tourist spots along with the fortress. These frescoes include ancient paintings by monks. Also, while climbing, you'll witness enigmatic views of the valley beyond the rock and learn about the ancient kingdom. Once tourists reach the top, they enjoy the engineering marvel. It is a question worth pondering. How did the island king and his people build the palace at such a height many centuries ago? Number 2. Kandy. Kandy is the second largest city in the country, and also the last ancient kingdom capital before the colonial era. It is located in the central province and is one of the corners of Sri Lanka's cultural triangle. The beautiful city has many attractions, due to which tourists are attracted towards it from worldwide. One of the main attractions of the city is the most sacred Buddhist temple in the world, the Temple of the Tooth. The temple was built in honor of the tooth of Buddha that was taken from India to Sri Lanka while Buddha was on his deathbed. Today, a ritual is held several times away in the temple, where the followers are given an opportunity to see the tooth. Wednesdays are dedicated to special ritual bathing of the tooth. It is said that the water from bathing has special healing powers. Another popular attraction is the National Museum of Kandy, right next to the temple. The city's unique and prosperous history can be explored via the museum, which lies where once a palace used to be. The museum has numerous artifacts that explain about Kandyan era. Apart from these attractions, the city's colorful streets, magnificent architecture, delicious food, and scenic lake views make it worth a visit. Do visit the Paradeniya Royal Botanical Garden as well. Number 1. Gala. Located in the country's southwest coast is a fortified old city and another of the country's UNESCO World Heritage Site, Gala. The Gala Fort was first built by the Portuguese and then fortified by Dutch later on. It is now an incredible city that is plentiful with beautiful Dutch villas and breathtaking seaside views. Gala is an excellent example of blended European and Asian architecture. The cobblestone alleyways and streets make the tourists drool in the charm of the past. Nowadays, the city is filled with modern hotels, restaurants, and souvenir shops, while snake charmers and buskers can be seen at the seawall. Tourists can explore the city or take a guided tour through the fortress to learn about its history and architecture. Thanks for watching.